Welcome to Frequency Matters, the RF and Microwave Update Series. I'm Pat Hindle, and I'm here with my co-host, Kristen Anderson. In the last episode, you and Gary covered the March test and measurement issue. So in this episode, we'll cover the March supplement, which is the cable and connector supplement that's an annual piece that we do, and it kind of lasts all year long as an update to what's going on in cables. And we have a very interesting cover story. It covers leaky cable antennas that are used for broadband antenna applications. So now they're getting Wi-Fi in aircraft, and a lot of those aircraft are using these type of cables as an antenna. They're good in any type of environment where you have a long tubular environment, so aircraft, tunnels, mines, and skyscrapers are good places where these antennas work. So we have CST doing the first part of the story, and they cover the design and modeling of these type of antennas. And then we have another piece by Gore that actually covers a product application, and that application is Wi-Fi and cellular service in aircraft. So we also have a few other technical features in there. Michael Coax takes a look at practical shielding effectiveness measurements of cable assemblies. And then we have Santron, who takes a look at RF cable stability that kind of goes beyond the mil specs and the IEC standards. So how can you make a more stable cable over time? And the last piece is by Anritsu, and they cover millimeter wave coaxial connectors. So up until a few years ago, millimeter wave coaxial connectors were very difficult, but now they actually have designs up to 110 gigahertz.
Wow. A lot of material.
Yes, a lot in that small supplement.
We do have a couple of products we featured this month, too. We have covering a spring-mounted measurement adapter by Spinner in Germany. They call this the Easy Dock, and evidently what it does is it centers itself. When testing, the Easy Dock first centers itself within the test device. We also cover next-generation interconnect cabling by Southwest Microwave. This is a family of SSBP RF and microwave cable coax contacts. And then we got three tech briefs this month. We cover Mari Microwave's Stability RF microwave cable assembly. We cover Gigalane's low-loss hermetic cable assembly. They call it the GLA and the GULA. GLA and GULA cable assemblies. And finally, Enphase Technologies with their self-contained computer-controlled measurement system. Sounds pretty interesting. So again, something in there for everyone. Good information going forward for new products.
Yeah, I really enjoy this supplement every year, so yeah. I'm glad we put that out.
Yeah.
So turning to the news, what would a Frequency Matters episode be without another merger announcement? Microsemi announced that they're acquiring Vitesse Semiconductor for $389 million. So this adds semiconductor technology to Microsemi's already big portfolio of devices, components, and systems. Mm-hmm. And it also gives them a footprint in the networking area where there's a lot of growth in cloud computing and Internet of Things. So I see them as becoming very vertically integrated now because they have semiconductor ICs, they have packaging, device components, and all the way up to systems. So quite the expansive vertical integration there.
And more on mergers and acquisitions. Announced some time ago, Axel Wireless would be what was acquired by Cobham, and evidently they're going to complete their integration by July of this year. So Axel Wireless, together with the test and measurement company Aeroflex, which was recently purchased by Cobham, they're going to become a new business unit called Cobham Wireless.
Right. Yeah, I saw that. It was really made sense now that they put all these pieces together and have a major wireless business unit.
Yeah. So I wanted to just bring out a little bit on the application. I guess for decades, Axel Wireless has been designing and developing DAS coverage solutions in places where communications infrastructure is challenging.
Right.
Some of their high-profile deployments were the Brazil World Cup Stadium, the Washington Transit Network, and the Pentagon. So this new integrated company is going to allow Axel to take advantage of the combined capabilities in the Cobham portfolio.
Wow.
So it just, again, makes sense.
Cobham had traditionally been more military-oriented, so this really gets them into the commercial wireless market in a heavy sense.
We'd like to see what they're going to come out with.
Yeah. And so I just returned from Mobile World Congress in Barcelona about a week ago, so that was a very interesting show. They actually reported attendance of 93,000 people.
Can't believe that.
That's unbelievable. Yeah. I mean, that's by far the largest wireless show in the world. And what was there, the hot topics were certainly what we've been talking about, 5G and IoT. So they were prevalent in all the booths there. And we saw a lot of 5G demos, which are very interesting. We actually took video demos of six 5G demos. So those are online on our YouTube channel.
Okay.
And we saw China Mobile, Keysight, Rodian Schwartz, NI, the Cobham Aeroflex and Ritsu all had those demos, so that would be very interesting.
Wow.
I think the one that caught my eye the most was the China Mobile one. They have this tile approach for massive MIMO. So they have these rectangular tiles that are multi-channel transceivers. They're two-channel now, but they're going to eight-channel. I imagine that will increase more. So they put a bunch of these tiles together to make a massive MIMO array. But what's cool is they can arrange them in different designs or even spell out characters in Chinese, which is what they did in the booth demo.
Wow.
So it's pretty cool.
Yeah, I can't wait to see some of those videos.
Yeah.
On YouTube now?
Yep, they're there. We have them, and we actually did some other demos. Another one that was very interesting was Rodian Schwartz was the only one that we saw there who was demoing four component carrier aggregation. So they were achieving data rates of 650 megabits per second. I saw other ones that were doing three component, but they were the only ones that I saw doing four components, so that's quite advanced.
Yeah.
On the Internet of Things point of view, there were also a lot of things on smart cities, medical applications, vehicle-to-vehicle communications, the connected home, so all that type of thing is really becoming real and being blown out into the industry.
Wow, excellent. Good stuff.
Yes.
I think Gary LaRude this week is at the Satellite Show in D.C.
Right.
I suppose he'll probably have his wrap-up online next week.
Yeah, it should be coming up
sometime soon. Yeah. We are very busy in trade show season. I'm sure all of you, our viewers, are as well. Certainly preparing for the MTTS show, which is early this year. It's in May in Phoenix. So whether you're attending or planning your participation as an exhibitor, now is the busy time to wrap up your travel plans, your presentation plans, your display plans.
Yeah.
EDICON as well, that's actually sooner, that's in April. We're in full swing as far as organizing the show. If you're planning to attend the show, we still have a discount available to you to register by the end of March.
Yep,
I think it's 50%?
50% off,
50%.
And that's ediconchina.com/registration.
Yep, I wanted to tell you too about two new exhibitors. So we did tell you we had space still available to participate as an exhibitor, and sure enough, just this past week, two came in. One from Egypt, a company called Consultix. They're into radio system platforms, test beds, test equipment, and design services. So they're planning on being there. Another new exhibitor, I don't know if I'm pronouncing this right, Xtaltec. X-T-A-L-T-Q. They're in China. Xtaltec Technologies. They're into oscillators, so TCXOs and OCXOs. They'll be exhibiting at the EDICON China show.
Yep, we're almost full. I mean, I think we have maybe one or two left, and that's it.
Yeah, so we're looking forward to that show very much.
Yes, and it's become very international, so a lot of the companies from the U.S., Europe, Middle East are attending.
Yep, and we're already making plans for next year, right? Same place, and
yes,
excellent. So I think that does about wrap up this episode. Yeah? I would like to thank our sponsor, of course, Mini Circuits, online at minicircuits.com. And also like to thank you for watching. We hope you'll join us again for the next episode of Frequency Matters.